This is the third in a series of three videos that describe the fundamental concepts of cloud service reliability. In this video, we'll discuss a process to help you design cloud services that meet your customers' expectations. So you want to create a service that's more reliable, but don't know where to start? This process can help you identify where dependencies in your service might cause something to go wrong, help you minimize the number of things that can go wrong, and to respond to them when they occur. It's an iterative process and takes into account the information you get from pre-release testing and the data you get from the deployed service after it's up and running. Now you've created the initial service design. It's time to determine where you might have issues in the service. Enter fault modeling, a process in which you identify possible failure points in the service and how to deal with them. First, build a complete component inventory. Choose the scenarios to model and capture possible failure points. List those points and the necessary design changes to cope with them in a document. Be sure to include how you will monitor the service to detect when issues occur in those areas. Use this information to create a fault model matrix or map in which you capture which service components are accessed when a customer performs each specific service task. Use this map to design fault handling mechanisms or coping strategies for each possible fault. Define coping mechanisms that enable components to fail quickly and switch to redundant components if necessary. Along with the coping strategies, define the service instrumentation requirements. Remember to monitor both at the component level and from the customer's perspective. This makes it easier to identify component level performance trends before they become widespread outages that impact the entire service. Use fault injection to verify the coping strategies work as you expect. Fault injection is software your team creates to break the service deliberately and programmatically. Test teams commonly use this technique before release. Though it may seem scary, you can use it on deployed services too. When you do that, target the coping strategies you have in place to validate them. Combined with recovery drills, fault injection can help you discover unexpected faults and harden the production environment. Then design new coping strategies to address the newly discovered faults and fix the strategies that did not work as you expected. It may sound obvious, but monitoring telemetry provides a way to troubleshoot potential problems with the live site. It can help you see how the service performs when handling real-world workloads and can be used to trigger alerting mechanisms when potential problems need to be escalated to the teams responsible for triage. To this last point, you can use live site telemetry to identify trends before they become outages. When you respond to this information quickly, you may be able to prevent widespread outages before they occur. Similar to fault injection, you can also analyze monitoring telemetry to improve the service from one release to the next. For more information about designing reliable cloud services, download the white paper, An Introduction to Designing Reliable Cloud Services, from this URL. You can watch the other videos in this series from this launch page.